in 2010, and I was a junior in high school at the time. And I went back as a staff in 2011. I ended up really liking and enjoying my time here at YLF. I think one of the main reasons I like the Youth Leadership Forum is there is a sense of community, especially amongst disabled youth, especially when we were placed in our small groups. I felt really connected and comfortable and like I could be myself. I even enjoyed being in a large group and hearing amazing speakers with disabilities share their stories. Some even shared their talents with us, which was cool to watch and see. For example, I remember watching Mark Joffrey, a talented guitar player, play guitar with his feet. I thought this was so cool and interesting. I couldn't wait to get home and look him up on YouTube. Another thing I liked about YLF was the resource fair. I got some good information about disability services just by attending and walking around from table to table, which was really cool. I learned about disability resources and tools that would be helpful to me later on in life. I especially enjoyed all the activities and events that YLF provided us. One event I will remember the most was probably the Hollywood dance. If you know me, I love to dance and go out and have fun. So in YLF, I even made some friends, and it was cool because one night I got to go out with all of them and dance the night away. The staff members from our year even let us attend a Sacramento Rivercats baseball game, which was amazing. It was nice to get out of the dorm rooms for a while and enjoy a big, giant, juicy hot dog. I remember sharing one of those big hot dogs with my friend Mike, one of the friends I made during YLF. He was awesome. He was so full of life. I will always remember him. I really loved every moment spent at YLF. Another one of my lasting friendships is with my good friend Dustin from my year. We would always text and FaceTime whenever we got the chance. I always loved talking to him. He brought a smile to my face. Me and my roommate also had a special bond. YLF put on a talent show for us even to participate in. It was a lot of fun. I remember my friend playing the air guitar while I lip sang to Journey's Don't Stop Believing. Ever since I attended YLF, I became more confident in myself and more comfortable with my own disability. I am a now loud, strong, disabled, proud individual in the community.
Woo!
YLF had really changed my life for the better. I have become an advocate in the community I care most about, the disability community. I volunteered at Yo Disabled and Proud, a really great organization to get involved with, started by Christina Mills. I participated through Yo on many campaigns on how to prevent bullying through Own My Power, or OMP, and disability history. I also volunteered at Community Resources for Independent Living in Hayward. I also had my YLF interview at CREO. And through CREO, I heard of this amazing youth program called DANI. Through DANI, we come together as a disabled community to discuss local issues affecting us, and we want to see change. Dining provides youth ages 14 through 28 leadership skills and training. We are all disability advocates in Dani. One of the huge things Dani does is teach disability history in local classrooms during the second week of October, otherwise known as Disability History Week. During Disability History Week, we provide presentations to students and teachers by informing them on issues and events that help shape the disability community, such as laws and leaders, for instance, the ADA and Ed Roberts. And for those of you that don't know what the ADA means, but I'm sure you all do, because it's the Americans with Disabilities Act. Students seem to love it when we come in the classroom and teach it. So Disability History Week passed because I, along with Dani, advocated and petitioned for it to pass. I spoke in front of school board members to get this topic passed. And I believe these presentations are good because it teaches students how to better understand disabilities and be more aware of people with disabilities. The thing great about talking to students is most likely if you educate them, they'll go back and teach their parents. And so passing disability history in schools and teaching it to hundreds of students was a huge accomplishment for us. Dani even got recognized and awarded by Senator Ellen Corbett for our accomplishments in teaching this. It feels great being involved and getting recognized for the work you are doing.